Strike.
So, the Blind Bandits have blind picked Triforce of Ginger as their starter, and Ruben's a poor mofo is starting off with Shy. Alright, no hits yet. Oh, but Shy gets that grab. Shy and Triforce of Ginger practice together, have a little bit of a history, and you know, I think they consider Shy to be the better player between the two of them, so it looks like the blind pick may have favored Ruben's support mofo, but you know, Triforce of Ginger can perform. And the thing about Luigi is his matchup is all about having to get in on a character. And let me tell you, if there's a character in Smash 4 who has tools for keeping people out, his name's Link. I mean, there's some others, but Link's definitely one of them. He's got those bombs, the boomerang, bow, just like a whole plethora of like things that he keeps on his person, but no one knows how. And they all work at keeping Luigi out, keeping those grabs from happening. Unfortunately, whiffing a grab from a large distance, not the best thing. For those of you who don't know how a crew battle works, there are four members in each crew, and each member of the crew has a set number of stocks. And the crew that eliminates all the other crew's stocks wins the crew battle. Ginger is taking stock one off of Shy. So we're going to go down to 1-7 stocks left on Ruben's poor mofo's side. But Shy bringing it right back.
Where
does
it go?
It's crazy. This crew battle is getting hype. Triforce Ginger carrying his weight here. Luigi grab combo is not a down throw for once, an up throw. Not sure if that's the best thing to do. I mean, it's sad when throws are just like obsolete, but I mean, when you've got a down throw and a combo game like Luigi's, there's really no reason to go for an up throw ever. I legit mean that. Unless you're maybe like on the center of the stage in Hobbard and they have high damage. Shy's trying to go for that Cyclone follow-up to his down throw. When performed correctly, he can't get kills out of it. Triforce the Ginger, taking Shy's second stock. Holding his weight for his team. Good job, Triforce the Ginger. We'll see what player Ruben's poor mofo decides to counterpick to finish off Triforce.
Alright, I've never done it, so I have no idea what I'm doing.
So as I was saying, each crew member has a set number of stocks, and that means Shy has been eliminated, but Triforce still has one stock, which means going into the next round of this crew battle, the counterpicked player would come in. Who's the counterpicked player?
I'm going to FD!
Is it G-Man?
Yeah. Oh, my God, we're nailed. Yep.
Alright, we're switching over to G-Man now. He's coming in to try to finish off Triforce Ginger's last stock. G-Man's goal here is going to be to take one stock from Triforce the Ginger before Triforce the Ginger to take one from him. If he can do that, he evens it up for the sets and everything's essentially on even playing ground except for the fact that the Blind Bandits will get the counter pick. So there's that one stock that Shy took.
Three! Hey! Three, two, one, go!
I don't know if that's the way crew battles work, but whatevs.
4%.
That was good. G-Man, looking like a champ out there.
Got this. You got it! Come on,
there we go. That's how Ruben's poor mofo is looking. Five stocks.
Yeah.
If I lose now, you know why!
So they were trying to do a like a fair start, and Triforce Ninja got shot a bow at G-Man while he was counting down to start. And currently the claim is that G-Man's death was because of that extra 4%. Thinking there should be a DQ on Triforce of Ginger. All good joking, of course. All good fun. Come on, Austin. What, that is one of the interesting, for those of you who can hear the other members of the crew cheering them on, that is an interesting point to be made about crew battles, is that percent doesn't carry over, it's only stocks. Which means, as long as G-Man takes a stock, it doesn't matter how much damage it takes. Triforce of Ginger, as long as he takes one stock of Triforce of Ginger, he goes into the next game with one stock and focus.
Yes!
He does it!
Who's in, brother?
Oh god. I had to click that once. There we go.
Town and City and Battlefield.
Triforce of Ginger did a great job, though. He took three stocks, losing only two himself.
I'm sorry for just totally screwing over this. I get it tomorrow. I'm so sorry about that.
Pushing buttons.
Here we go.
CLL agrees it was the 4%.
Yeah,
that's the actual character disqualification. G-Man still has two stocks.
So, the counter pick from the Blind Bandits is going to be Summer Heat. He's going his main Yoshi.
Take my stock.
Yeah.
Okay, so I just had a heart.
Wow. So once again, we see a Sonic SD.
And he started the egg roll before the go happened. Every other team is cheating.
I did not.
Bull. Hold up.
All right.
You got this.
Duck Hunt stage for round three of this mock crew battle. J-Man's fighting from the disadvantage position, only one stock, and he wants to get two off of Summer Heat. Because there's no way that someone can come out of this match even. Whoever wins this match has put their team in a one stock advantage position. Or if Summer Heat kills G-Man right now, two stock advantage position. G-Man going for those classic Sonic combos, up B to up air. For whatever reason, the knockback on a lot of G-Man's like upward moves is like exactly the same range as an up B. So it's just like, why not? Go up there and do an up air. The crew's all cheering on the
enemy.
Whoa! Summer Heat! What, was that an F tilt?
I goofed it.
Was that an F tilt?
That was F smash.
That was an F smash. G-Man losing his second stock to Summer Heat. Well, looks like we've got... It looks like we've got Ninja Assassin stepping up for Rubens and poor Mofo. He's two stocks behind. He needs to take two stocks off Summer Heat without losing any stocks just to even up his team's position in this mock crew battle. Town and City sounds like the stage we're going to. Ninja Assassin versus Summer Heat. Just has Shane going Rosalina, one of the characters he plays, and word of mouth, I heard that he had some pretty good results in today's Swiss with her. Looks like Ninja Sashin's opting to keep Luma separated, not going into the Rosaluma stance of Rosalina's character. Not totally sure how much I agree with that, but it's not working out for him so far. Summer Heat's not killing Luma, which is generally the reason you don't want to stay in the stance. That and the Rosalina loses a lot of her up-close potential whenever characters get in on her. It's also harder to keep characters out. Alright, that was a up-air kill on Luma, followed by an up-smash kill on Rosalina, thus ending the lives of both Rosalina and Luma, the full character. Of course, Rosalina does still have one more stock to work with. Let's see if Ninja Sashin can maybe catch up, at least take one stock off Summer Heat, and for his team's sake, hopefully too. At this point, even if he beats Summer Heat, Ruben's poor Mofo will still be at a one-stock disadvantage. Room for Ninja Sashin right now, just because he's Rosalina. I love Rosalina. She's such a babe. S-tier waifu right there. Also, I'd like to. I also just want to see a hype crew battle, you know? I want to see this get close, so. And. Oh, Ninja Sashin going for that very nice fair to up smash combo. When you miss the tech on that fair, if it cancels into the ground like that, you get spiked and you can follow up with a lot of stuff, up smash being one of them. So Summer Heat is out one stock now. Ooh, and there it is again, fair to forward tilt. But Yoshi's forward smash beats out Rosalina's in terms of timing. Good DI by Ninja Sashin living it though. Ooh, and Yoshi's getting all these on-stage spikes with his fair. That up smash is gonna take it though. Ninja Sashin taking one stock off Summer Heat. And the last member of Ruben's A Poor Mofo has to hold down two stocks against Blind Bandit's five stocks. A grim position to be in, but Jaxus is the top PR member here in Salem. If someone can perform, it's him.
Sonic speed.
This is a tense 2v5 setting. G-Man!
No.
Whoa. Alright. G-Man's out. I hope that his the moral support he's missing.
I don't have my headphones. Oh well. No, I meant my good headphones.
I hope the moral support he's missing won't be missed too much. Shy and Kendrick, make sure Jaxus gets support now that G-Man's gone.
Yeah. Alright. I only have to take five.
You do. Yeah, you got this.
Easy money.
Oh, you guys are... Oh.
Down the last one.
Oh, okay.
Alright, it looks like this match is finally about to go underway. Get underway.
Oh my god, that is loud. Alright. You're one stock down.
Alright. And this match is about to get underway. We went to Smashville.
One, go!
Jax is going his main, Sheik, of course. And he is fighting to take all the stocks. For Jax to have a really solid chance, he's got to get one stock off Summer Heat before Summer Heat can get any off of him. I mean, honestly, if Summer Heat took this stock and then Jaxus still won it overall, that would be, like, so hype. Like, I would just lose it. But it seems unlikely, so that's what Jaxus is going for here. Jaxus Jax is keeping Yoshi out, mostly. Getting good punishes for the attacks Yoshi's landing on his shield. Ooh. Summer Heat going for an up air through the bottom of that platform. Jax is not letting it happen. Oh, and he gets that fair. Jaxus is just trying to beat out everything with frame data of the character, as Sheik is known as. Oh, those needles and egg trade. That's one of the funniest projectile trades I've ever seen, actually. Needles off stage, keeping Yoshi at bay. Jaxus did not pick up that edgeguard, though. He's gotta be careful. Yoshi is in heavy rage now, so something could end his stock if he's not careful. And a self-destruct on Summer Heat's part means Jaxus does safely take this game. The score now 2-4.
Albert and Congo.
And Churro's stepping up for Blind Bandits.
Yeah.
Get that dancing support.
I know. If people not currently, that's gonna help pack off.
Oh, okay.
And fire.
Hey, you guys, when you get to my Wii U, just take the setup apart and bring all the individual pieces over here and I'll package them. Thank you. Alright. Our venue is closing down as we finish off this mock crew battle. There are only two potential matches left, depending on how Jaxus performs. He is in a heavy position here. Churro opted to lock Little Mac in as his character, which is awesome and fun. That said, Little Mac, with his Little Mac, being a character that's very hard to recover with, can suffer heavily against a character like Sheik, who could take you very far off the stage with lots of fair strings. So, honestly, if there was one character Churro could lock himself into who Jaxus would have a okay chance at getting two stocks off of safely, it would be Little Mac. And he does manage to get that KO punch offline with a down tilt. Ooh, nice wall jump on Churro's part. Definitely helping out Little Mac's recovery quite a bit. But the needles are going to take it. Jaxus making the score 2-3. He's bringing this back for his team. Jax is getting in risky at a risky percent range now. Of course, he is still Sheik, so he can pretty much recover from anywhere. Oop, that was a good reverse momentum to back air. It outspaced the forward smash and then came in for a really good punish. Good shielding on the Little Mac jabs. Oh, but Little Mac is going to take one stock off of Jaxus. Gotta be wary of that KO punch. Then again, it doesn't matter how much damage Jaxus takes this match. As long as he takes one stock off of Churro, he still has his one stock left at 0% to take Brobear's two stocks. And Jaxus manages to get his shield up, being the fast faller that he is. Oh, and he does a really good job reading that counter and punishing it hard. That's probably it for Little Mac, given the fact that Jaxus has needles. But Churro did what he needed to do to set Brobear up for success. He got one stock off of Jaxus. Jaxus has now taken three stocks and lost only one himself, and we're going to the final round of the Smock crew battle.
Go better?
Robear dropping in as the anchor for the Blind Bandits. Both these players are very worthy anchors. They are current ranked number one and number two members of the Salem PR, and Jaxus and Robear respectively. And they are also the team captains. Jaxus failing to SD. Tried to make it as far, as close to the center of the bottom of the stage as possible, apparently.
I want that song back. Alright. Let's go. Anyone's?
Throw it out.
I'll go over here.
Alright. Jaxus has his work cut out for him. Robear is a really good player, so getting two stocks off without losing any is a challenge. But Jaxus can do this. He just has to leave. Robear? He got put in a nice position, thanks to his teammates. They did a great job of taking lots of stocks off of everyone who was a Jaxus, basically. And because of that, Churro was able to... Churro was able to get one stock off Jaxus before he made it here. So Jaxus did a good job escaping the back throw to flip kick spike attempts. That's something that he knows how to do himself as a Zero Suit Second. And he also did a good job punishing a whiffed grab with a fair a little while ago. Just wanted to say that. It happened like 20 seconds ago now, but whatever. Oh, Robear gets that taser, and he's not quite getting the follow-up he wanted from it. Robear did get stage counterpick of Battlefield for being the one who came in last to this game. Which is going to help him out a lot because Battlefield is very easily Zero Suit's best stage. Oh, and that's going to be it. Robear, without losing any stocks, does take one off of Jaxus, making Blind Bandits the winner. Good game to the crews. Robear got that clutch loose kick. And I believe we're going to have to break down now because our venue is closing. But